on radio, 5 desk priority.
Go 5 desk.
I need someone from the bomb squad to call me at the front desk.
I'm Sergeant Matt Taylor, and I'm the officer in charge of the Detroit Police Bomb Squad. I'm here to talk to you about a serious incident which took place recently on Detroit's east side. On September 22nd, 2016, a gentleman who was cleaning out the personal effects of a deceased military veteran came across what he believed to be a hand grenade. This gentleman, rather than calling 911, picked up the grenade, put it in his car, drove a considerable distance in heavy traffic to the Detroit Police 5th Precinct at Mack and Connor. He then got out of his car, picked up the grenade again, carried it to the front entrance, and attempted to give it to the police personnel at the station. As a result, the precinct had to be evacuated for a lengthy period of time while myself and the rest of the bomb squad were summoned. Once the area was safely evacuated, a Detroit police bomb tech approached the grenade in a protective suit and secured it safely in a special container. We further investigated the grenade to a safe location, and we were able to confirm that it was, in fact, a live, high-explosive fragmentation grenade from the Korean War era. The bomb squad safely destroyed the grenade using a countercharge. That's a technique where we essentially put more explosives on top of the item and then set it all off from a safe distance. We talked to the gentleman who brought the grenade in, and we believe he meant well, and he won't face any charges. But the bottom line is that by handling and transporting this grenade on his own, he put himself, everyone around him, and the officers at the precinct at serious risk. He also unnecessarily disrupted police services to the area while the precinct was locked down and evacuated. Believe it or not, incidents like this happen more often than you might think, where unsuspecting and well-meaning people encounter military ordnance, commercial explosives, or illegal fireworks, and attempt to transport or handle the items themselves. This needs to stop before someone gets seriously hurt or killed. You may not know, but old explosives and pyrotechnics actually can become more dangerous rather than less dangerous as they age. So please, don't think that just because something is old, that it's not a serious threat to your safety. Bomb squads frequently encounter explosives that are 50 and 60 years old or even older. And I promise you, this stuff can still work just fine, even after all that time. So please, Detroit, if you ever encounter something that you think may be military ordnance, such as hand grenades or artillery projectiles, commercial explosives like dynamite, detcord, or blasting caps, or even illegal fireworks, please treat it as an emergency, call 911, evacuate the area, and let the police, fire department, and the bomb squad come to you. Please do not attempt to handle it or transport it yourselves. I'm Sergeant Taylor from your Detroit Police Bomb Squad. Please be safe, Detroit.